In this video, we will cover basic VLink client configuration. Firstly, let's clarify that this tutorial is intended for users of standard VLink, not VLink TIFF. Now, what exactly is a client in VLink? A client refers to a user or device login within the VLink system. To add a new client, click the Add button. From there, you'll see a drop-down menu specifying the type of client you wish to add. For a control panel client, select one of the options prefixed with VCP. Here, you'll input a login name and password, which will be utilized for accessing the control panel. Additionally, you can set the selector talk listen name visible on the control panel for this user. Now let's explore the various options available for clients. The IFB option designates a client as an IFB destination, useful for interrupting audio feeds when a talk path is initiated from the control panel. Ideal for on-air talent needing constant monitoring with periodic queues. The ISO option designates a client as an ISO destination, enabling interruptions to assigned feeds and activating a private talk path back to the control panel. Perfect for isolating camera feeds for private instruction. Enabling the recording option will capture the audio from the client for archival purposes. Next, we will cover the other client types. Adding a VLink device interface client follows the same process, typically utilized for Dante connections, facilitating connections to RTS Atom and Odin frames. The SIP client type is typically used for connecting external phone lines for dial-in or dial-out functionality. The video client type has an input field for the URL of an HLS video stream. This allows the video to be viewed on the WebRTC control panel. Only HLS video is supported. RTSP and NDI client types are used to connect the audio of external feeds to VLink. This capability is useful for monitoring program feeds. Next, we will show how to set up a party line. To set up a party line, navigate to Group Configuration. Create a new group and assign a selector talk listen name. The party line has been created and can now be assigned to a control panel. To complete the configuration, navigate to the Client Configuration menu. Select a client and click the Selector Assignments button. This menu is used to define which selectors will be available on the control panel. Select a client from the menu on the left and then click one of the buttons in the middle to add it to the control panel. When user 1 logs into the control panel, they will be able to talk or listen on the example party line. Lastly, we will cover the template feature. The template feature allows you to reuse existing configurations across multiple clients. Highlight two or more clients, and then click the Link Selector Assignments button. Now, if the selector assignments are changed on one of these control panels, the change will be reflected onto the other control panel. This concludes our basic VLink client configuration video. Please watch our other videos to learn more about VLink.